I remember texting my dad. He was like, oh, how's it going? I was like, I'm on the bus. And he sent me a message back.
Going well then.
No, he said, yeah, good boy, it's cheaper than a taxi. I was like, he doesn't get this.
You don't get it. It's Magic, Ronan Keating, and I am joined by the brilliant Will Young. And Will, how are you?
I've got a giggle. I think it's you.
It's not me, it's you.
You're naughty.
It's not.
And then
I'm not.
Make me...
Well, the last time we had you on Magic Breakfast, it was pretty ridiculous.
You make me.
Yeah, I have that sort of face. That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
That I have a funny face.
Yes.
Yeah, thanks
no,
very much.
Absolutely not.
No.
You have a humorous face.
I want to take you. It does. I want to take you down memory lane. I've got a bunch of photos here from your past. Beautiful, brilliant photos from your career. And I want you to explain what you see. What these photos bring, what memories these photos bring back. So let's kick it off. This photo here, you with the brilliant Brian May. Do you remember this?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
You know what? This is so brilliant to see these pictures. It's one of the things that I love most about my job. I'm so lucky that I get to have so many pictures that people have taken.
Absolutely.
You know, it's quite rare, isn't it?
It is.
But anyway, so this was just after Pop Idol, Golden Jubilee. I wasn't meant to be singing We Are The Champions,
right?
But Phil Collins didn't want to do it because he was too busy drumming.
Okay.
Which is fair enough, because he was the drummer.
Well, I mean,
So last minute. And also, bear in mind, like, I would literally just come from like drama school.
Yeah.
And they were like, Phil Collins would like you to sing with Queen. And I was like, what?
What's happened?
You know, what's happened to my life?
Yeah, that's brilliant.
And I was really bad in the dress rehearsal. And I actually swore on stage and it went out all the way down the mall. Apparently only me and Ozzy Osbourne were the two people that swore.
You can expect it from Ozzy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But not nice.
Not
like
Will
Young.
No, definitely not.
And then it came together.
Beautifully.
On the
you must have been terrified. I mean, I would be terrified.
I was a bit terrified. Yeah. But I suppose because maybe I was just so new to it and so naive, in a good way.
Yeah.
So, you know, my barometer was not, you know.
You weren't.
Well,
my first gig was
on TV.
I know.
And then I remember being backstage and sitting next to Eric Clapton.
Oh,
and I was like,
it's ridiculous, isn't it?
What's going on? And then Annie Lennox was like, do you want to come and sit in my dressing room? I was like, what?
Brilliant.
Yes.
Yes, please.
So it was so surreal. And even in the gardens of Buckingham Palace,
I know.
By the way.
That's where the dressing rooms were.
Yeah.
In the gardens at the back of the palace.
And the stage was in the gardens.
Okay, moving on. Photograph number two. Sort of racy looking photo here.
Different look, isn't it?
Yeah, very different look. It suits you. Looks good. Tell us, what are we looking at?
Well, we're looking at me, 2012, in the Savoy Theatre, playing the MC in Cabaret. I mean, he's crazy.
Yeah.
He's a sucker.
Crazy, larger than life character. Brilliant.
A fat suit made of balloons. I got to wear that outfit. I got to wear frock coats. I dressed in a romper. I mean, it was just crazy.
Did you feel it also?
Screaming at the audience.
Yeah. But did it challenge you? I mean, it must have been a huge challenge.
It challenged as an
artist.
It scared me.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I had such a great director and he was just like, you just go for it.
Yeah.
It sort of transformed me as an artist after that, because I thought, right, I've done that. Now I want to bring more of that into my pop. I started doing weirder videos, basically. Probably one of my proudest moments ever.
And rightly so.
Yeah, that.
Next photo. Look at this one. Oh, this is a good moment. We all remember this. This is you.
Oh, yes.
This is you in Victoria with your battle bus. We all love those battle buses. They were brilliant.
This is the last week of Pop Idol.
Yeah.
I bought that jumper, I remember, from Urban Outfitters in High Street Ken in London. With my student loan, which wasn't going on what it was meant to be going on. And we got these buses, me and Gareth Gates, for the last week leading up to the final. It was like the most genius idea. They were called the battle buses and they had our faces on them.
That's right.
And we drove around the country.
All up and down the country, I remember.
I mean, it was like,
everyone was trying to spot the battle bus.
That last week was so much fun and we went on all the TV shows. And it was just, you know, because I knew it was coming to an end in a nice way, I was like, oh, I'm going to enjoy this so much. Yeah.
Right.
And I remember texting my dad going, he was like, oh, how's it going? And I was like, I'm on the bus. And he sent me a message back.
Going well then.
No, he said, yeah, good boy, it's cheaper than a taxi. And I was like, he doesn't get this.
You don't get it. was huge.
Yeah.
And what do you take away from that more than anything else, from that the whole process?
I take away that I just don't think someone who was openly gay, like I was, a politics student, posh, and not very cool, could have been given or ever given a record contract. That's why that show was perfect for someone like me, because all I really had was my voice. I wasn't even writing songs then.
Yeah.
And I just thought, well, I don't know how am I going to get, who's going to sign me?
Yeah.
But that kind of show, that's why those shows are great. And they still are great.
They still are, yeah, absolutely.
Because you just, it's another chance.
I'm to wrap up on this photo. It's 20 years next year, is that right?
It'll be 20 years in February next year.
Oh, how will you celebrate? Is the show doing anything? Do you know?
It'd be great if they did.
Yeah.
You know?
They should.
I think they should.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be, I think it would be great. And, but I want to try and do something every month.
Mm.
Because also, like, I got voted for.
Yes.
Quite unique.
Yeah, that's it.
You know,
the
so
nation wanted
like,
you to be the, you know, their pop idol. Yeah.
So I would like to start try and do something every month that is kind of giving back.
Yeah, lovely.
Yeah.
Can you remember all of the songs you performed across the weeks?
Yes.
And that's what you should, there you go. One of them a week.
Oh, that's a good one.
There you go. I mean, let's go back there.
The man,
they were great,
aren't you?
Weren't they? They were great, great moments. Okay, moving on. Next photo. Here you are.
Oh, well, this is the best, really, isn't
this
it?
This is good. This is a photo of you with a Christmas present of some, because it was the Magic's Awkward Present Wrapping Challenge back in 2019.
Yes, I have a sort of an interesting sort of lumberjack style hat on.
Well, it takes me back to my first Late Late performance when I wore a cap backwards on my head. How's that look about it?
We won't
talk about it, though.
Oh, my gosh, it does, doesn't it?
It does, yeah, I like it.
It was with Harriet Scott.
Yes.
It was awkward for a number of reasons.
Yeah, because you were with Harriet Scott.
Because I was with Harriet Scott. Yeah. She couldn't keep her hands off me. This was pre-COVID times.
Yes, I know, exactly. 2019, we're talking.
She actually said to me, can you just wrap me up and take me home for Christmas?
There you go.
And but then weird, leave me under the tree.
That's odd, isn't it?
You've got a family woman.
Yeah, she just wanted to be part of your world, you know, just be there in your life.
She wanted to be part of my Christmas.
That's it.
Yeah.
Are you a Christmas person?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Never used to be.
Right.
I get more and more elaborate in my Christmas. So last Christmas, I gave you.
Yes, that was gonna go there.
I decided to get giant inflatables.
Brilliant.
But put them all on the inside of my house. So if you walk past my house,
there's this big blown up
every window.
Santa Claus in the window
is just blown up.
It's kind of scary, though. I was going to say kind of scary.
Giant gingerbread men.
Yeah.
Like squeezing help
us,
against.
Help us get out. Help us get out of Will's house.
Kids were crying.
Yeah.
Because up the road, they'd really gone for it.
Yeah.
The bigger houses.
Okay, yeah. So keeping up with
like,
the Joneses.
I was like, I can't compete with that. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is subvert it and make kids cry.
Take the outside inside. That's it.
My favourite bit was when I came out of my house and I saw this woman outside taking pictures, and she was sort of wrapped in foil.
Oh.
You know, like that kind of stuff that marathon runners get when they finish. It's Vivian Westwood.
I thought you were going to say it was Harriet Scott. It was Vivian Westwood.
It was Harriet Scott! Well, maybe it was. So dressed as Vivian Westwood.
Vivian Westwood was outside your house taking pictures.
She lives in the area.
Yeah.
It was her and her partner or husband. I don't know if they're partner or husband. And she was taking pictures of my...
Of your gingerbread man trying to escape.
Of my creepy gingerbread man.
Maybe you inspired the next collection.
And penguins.
Yeah. Penguins are... Wow,
I've
I could
see
that
little,
on
I've got little baby penguins.
Yeah.
Trapped in the window.
I think they'd be scary. Very scary.
I don't know what I'm going to do this year.
I know. You're going to have to top that.
I'm going to wrap up Harry.
Should be very happy about that. Okay, next one. Look at this.
This is you. Look, I look such a little bairn.
So young in this. This is the first album.
Okay, this is the first album. Mm-hmm. Oxford Street, HMV, album signings. Remember those?
I remember those. Used to shut down the street.
Remember that?
Yeah.
It was brilliant. But I'll tell you a really funny moment. So I had a security guard called Malcolm, and he was like, if someone was coming in for a big old kiss, but it was just seeming a bit too
much
scary, just touch his knee or his foot, and he'll gently step in. You know, just to keep everyone safe.
Yeah.
And someone came along and she was coming in for a good old
kiss,
smacker.
Right on the lips.
And I was touching Malcolm's leg.
He was having a sleep.
He was just ignoring me.
Oh, no.
She came right across the table.
No, can't deal.
It was
lipstick all over the face.
It was everything.
Yeah. Okay, final picture on memory lane. It's you. this is you with a JCB. No, I'll tell you what this is. This is you at Glastonbury.
Ah.
Yeah.
Yes, Glastonbury. So I decided to wear a wig.
It is a wig, thank God.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I knew that Lily Allen had one year, she was walking around dressed as a monkey or something, so no one recognised her, and it meant that she could get around.
Just do
Glastonbury.
Her thing,
And I've been going to Glastonbury for years, and it did become quite difficult to get around, and then I would get panicky because I'd be like, "There's lots of people, and now I can't go anywhere."
Yeah,
and I don't mean it in a, you know, like, oh,
yeah, yeah,
famous.
No.
I thought if I just get a wig,
yeah.
People won't look, or they'll second guess, and then I'm gone.
You're gone by then.
I'm off, I'm dancing, I'm in mud.
I'm at the pyramid stage.
Yeah. Yeah. The cider, I'm throwing up. Yeah, exactly. I'm being thrown in the
I'm
air.
I'm sleeping in a corner. In the urinals,
My face is in a kebab.
Yeah, exactly. You
know, and happiness.
And nobody knows it's you.
And no one knows it's me.
It's
and
great.
I'm
That's Glastonbury.
So happy.
Yeah.
So I wore this wig, and the thing is, and I've never told anyone this, but I'm going to tell you this. Because I'm so vain, I bought the wig. I went and got a haircut.
I love that.
For the wig.
So you got the wig cut or your own haircut?
I got the wig cut.
Oh my, it's got to fit the face. It actually looks like a good wig.
If you saw that, would you know that was me?
No, I wouldn't. I mean, there's other people I see there. I don't see Will Young.
Sort of trying to go for a sort of, I've got a headband round.
It's Glastonbury, you know, wellies, shorts. And a cup of beer.
It was probably about, I don't know, 8 a.m.
Oh,
and
lovely.
That was when my mum first came to Glastonbury as well.
Brilliant.
Who is now a regular Glastonbury girl.
Will you go this year?
Yes, I'm performing.
Yeah.
I forgot.
Oh, hello.
I think so.
Yes.
No, not this year. Next year. Sorry.
Okay.
20.
Is that been released
22.
Yet?
Well, I was doing it.
So they've just pushed it back to next year. Because it's happening in September, a version of.
That legend slot.
Oh, yeah.
I really want that legend slot.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Anything?
But when you think of the people that have been there, I mean, we've got a few more years.
It's a few more years.
We've got a few more years before we get it, yeah.
That's true.
You know? And the only reason you're not on the Legends slot is because you're too young. So you will be there. If you think Kylie's, 50, and she's been doing it for probably 35 years? Yeah.
Oh, maybe not the Legends slot.
And then Barry Gibb was before that, and Barry's obviously been doing it a little bit longer than you and I. So, you've got time. You will be in the Legends slot,
yes,
Lionel Richie, yeah.
Absolutely. I'll get to that legend story.
You will get there. You will. Yeah. You deserve it. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for taking us down this this wonderful journey of photographs and memories.
Are we going to go through the other pictures?
No more pictures.
We don't do that on radio?
No, we don't do that on radio. We'll do that.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll do that later.